And welcome back. Well, our next guest is usually here showing us fabulous jewels, but today she's talking about something much more personal.
Anna Zuckerman is a designer and owner of A.C. Zuckerman Jewelers in Mequon. She is here today to talk about heart disease and why this cause is so important to her. Good morning,
good
Anna.
Good to see you.
Well, good morning again. Thank you again for having me.
Yeah, it's always so nice to have you on the show, and usually we're talking about beautiful jewelry, and you're wearing some beautiful jewelry, but today we're talking about something different that's very near and dear to your heart.
Well, as we all know, February is the National Heart Awareness Month, where we encourage women to go red, wear red as much as they can to show their support for the Heart Association.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And this is an important issue to you as well. How did you get involved in the American Heart Association?
I've been involved with the American Heart Association for probably a little bit over a decade. My husband was a cardiologist, and seeing him save so many people, so many lives, absolutely inspired me to come on board and see what is it that we could do for the community.
Mm-hmm.
It's been a wonderful journey for the past 10 years, and certainly have a compelling story to tell.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. This information is about the American Heart Association event that's coming up, and you're a very proud sponsor mm-hmm. of the 2011 Heart Ball. This is not going to be the first year that you've attended the Heart Ball.
No. We've chaired the Heart Ball several times. I had chaired the Go Red for Women last May. And the reason why this year is so incredibly important to me is less than a year ago, my husband, who was a cardiologist, passed away from a stroke.
Mm-hmm.
And he was in a coma for 30 days at Frederick Hospital. And I sat with him every single day and watched and saw how much research, how much medical care goes into trying to save a life.
Mm-hmm.
And I cannot tell you how passionate I am about supporting the Heart Organization, because they had done absolutely everything to save my husband's life. Unfortunately, they did not succeed, but the memory will always go on forever, and will always be supportive of the Heart Association.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful picture of your family there. You have two children.
Yes.
How old are they now?
They're 5 and 3. He passed away, and the kids were 4 and 2. And we were dealing with our issues, but
mm-hmm.
They know that Mom has been very, very good supporter, and Mom has been proactive within our community.
Mm-hmm.
And I would like to talk about several things that American Heart Association does for our community, for the state of Wisconsin,
mm-hmm.
and several programs that they came up with. Heart Ball that is happening February 12th is the main event that raises the most money every year for the research. And the money, of course, goes to fund universities for the research, fund programs. We help, we encourage inner city women, teach them about heart disease, about the prevention. This year, American Heart Association came up with a Life Simple 7, which is exactly 7 points to follow and try to prevent heart disease.
Mm-hmm.
And when you go online to American Heart Association, there's this particular booklet that you could get if you could zoom in on this. And
mm-hmm.
what the seven items they're talking about is basically what it would be to keep us healthy,
mm-hmm.
Involving quitting smoking, watching what you eat, staying active as much as you can, controlling sugars, controlling cholesterol, blood pressure, and of course, trying to live a stress-free life with health as well.
Mm-hmm.
But this is available online, and just like the rest of the information. Just a little factor that this year, American Heart Association has funded Wisconsin another $16 million.
Wow.
And over the past 40 years, our state had gotten $68 million. So we're trying to put as much as we can into the research just to see how many more lives we could save.
Mm-hmm. What happens at the Heart Ball? If somebody's interested in attending, can they still go to the event? And what will happen there?
Yes, you could still go online and still buy. We encourage larger companies to sponsor a table
mm-hmm.
or buy individual tickets. The event itself is happening at the Sister Hotel. Starting at 6 o'clock, we will have a silent auction as well as the live auction. Being a jeweler, we not only that we sponsor the event, but we also try to give the items that we design, whether it's jewelry, rings, necklaces for the auction. This year, we're giving away a ring, and it's shown right there on the screen.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And this would be auctioned on the voice auction. And but the tickets are still available, and we will have a fabulous band, and we'll try to make this event as fun as possible with, of course, this absolutely significant cause.
Yeah. Yeah, that is a beautiful ring, and that's
great
something that
honor.
Attendees can bid on while attending the Heart Ball. And it, you know, you mentioned getting different participation and reaching people, women in particular, in the inner city. I think that's a mistake that we so often make, is that heart disease is something that affects men, when in reality it affects a lot of women too.
Heart disease is the number one killer. So a third of all the deaths in the United States is caused by either stroke or heart disease. Now, I'm an immigrant myself, and when we came to this country, it took years to understand that you cannot eat everything under the roof and gain weight and still be okay. It took me years to persuade my family to slow down, get away from junk food. And slowly, 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 there is less and less and less heart disease that I see and my family as well. And I compare that to the brand new immigrants, because we don't have the knowledge yet. So we, between the African Americans, between Latino, between Russian communities and Serbian communities, there's a lot of education that we fund out there for these people to come in, sit down, have a lecture, and understand a little bit more about heart disease.
A very important cause, and one that obviously is dear to your heart, and a great way to honor your late husband as well. Here's the information for the American Heart Association Heart Ball. It's going on again Saturday, February 12th, and that'll be at the Pfister Hotel. You can attend. You can also, as a large company, sponsor a table, as Anna mentioned. A.C. Zuckerman is a wonderful sponsor of this event. Here is the location and information for A.C. Zuckerman so that you can go there, visit, and take a look at some of the beautiful jewels that are inside of their showroom. They're located on Mequon Road, and here's the in Mequon. Here's the website. It's aczuckermanjewelers.com. The number is 262-240-0111. Thanks so much for being here, Anna.
Thank you guys for having me.
Nice to have you.
And before we go, Anna, you're going to be back with us 1 week from today to talk about Valentine's Day gift ideas, but even more exciting, you're actually giving one away to a lucky viewer, right?
We're giving away Diamond Heart, which we had just designed.
Beautiful.
And, I guess the viewers could go online and pre-register, and we'd love to do that. A lucky winner would have this beautiful, beautiful Diamond Heart.
It's gorgeous. It's a $1,500 value, beautiful necklace for Valentine's Day. Perfect timing. And the way that you can enter is to go to themorningblend.com and click on contest to enter to win. Again, that beautiful heart pendant designed by A.C. Zuckerman Jewelers and Mequon. Thanks, Anna, for doing that.
Thank
fun contest.
Thank you so much again for having me. And next week, on to the happier things, Valentine's.
Yeah,
love is in the air.
Next week.
Yeah,
thank you.
Thank you.